In the PreTrig review part 13, we're going to study rational functions. Now, we say a function is a rational function when there is a function living in the numerator and there's another function living in the denominator. And for the purposes of this review exercise, we're going to abbreviate numerator of x over denominator of x. Now, a root will occur when the numerator is equal to 0, but the denominator is not 0. It actually equals a number, and that's what we're showing here. Sort of a shorthand way to think about it is pictured here, where the numerator is 0, but the denominator is not 0. It equals some number. So you can think of it like 0 over a number. A vertical asymptote will occur when the denominator of the rational function is 0, but the numerator is not 0. So if we look over here at the shorthand notation, we say a vertical asymptote occurs when the numerator is equal to some number and the denominator is equal to 0. A hole will occur in the rational function when both the numerator and the denominator are 0 at the same time. And that will occur when the numerator and denominator have common factors. So you can think of this one as 0 over 0. Let's look at example A. We want to name the roots, vertical asymptotes, or holes of this function. So to look for those, we need to factor both the numerator and the denominator. So if we look at the numerator first, using the AC method, we're going to need two numbers that multiply to be positive 8, but that add to be a negative 9. You go through the factors of 8, and you get there pretty quickly in this case. We see that it's going to be negative 8 and negative 1 that will get us there. Now if we take 2x squared minus 9x plus 4, we know that what we have to do with those two numbers is split up that middle term. So now we have 2x squared minus 8x minus x plus 4. Now we're going to factor two at a time, so we can factor out a 2x, and we have left x minus 4. From the second two, we can only factor out a 1, so we put a minus 1, and we have x minus 4. Now the reason we put the minus sign there was because of this minus sign right here coming straight down. Now we see that these two terms have an x minus 4 in common. So we factor out the x minus 4 and we have left 2x minus 1. So this numerator just became x minus 4 times 2x minus 1. Now if we look at the factorization for the denominator, and again we'll use the AC method, we need two numbers that multiply to be negative 8, but that are going to add to be negative 2. So we start going through the factors of negative 8, looking for what we need, and we see that a negative 4 and a positive 2 will give us what we need. So that means x squared minus 2x minus 8 is going to factor to x minus 4, x plus 2. We can put that up here. Now, remember, the reason that we could write these two down quickly, immediately, in one step here as x minus 4, x plus 2, was because the leading coefficient here is a 1. We couldn't do that in factoring the numerator, right? When we got these two, the minus 8 and the minus 1, we couldn't write down x minus 8, x minus 1, because the leading coefficient was not 1, it was a 2. And in fact, you can see, if we had tried to incorrectly factor it as x minus 8, x minus 1, when you first went to check, and you multiplied x times x, and you only got x squared instead of 2x squared, you would know that you made an error in your factorization. So that's why that one does not work. We are ready to move on with the rest of the problem. We can look for the roots in f of x by remembering that roots occur when the numerator is equal to 0, but the denominator is not equal to 0. The denominator equals a number. In this case, looking at our function here, we see that the numerator will equal 0 at x equals 4 and x equals 1/2. However, the denominator also equals 0 at x equals 4, so therefore x equals 4 is not a root. So the only root of f of x will be when x is equal to 1/2, and so therefore the root is going to be 1/2, 0. Vertical asymptotes of a rational function occur when the denominator is equal to 0 and the numerator is not 0. In other words, the numerator equals a number. So the vertical asymptotes are going to occur at x equals negative 2. Again, x equals 4 cannot be a vertical asymptote because even though the denominator is 0, the numerator is also 0 at that same x value, so it is not a vertical asymptote. Holes of a rational function occur when both the numerator and the denominator are 0 at the same x value. So notice we said one of the quick ways to find them is to look for the common factors. Easy to see in this case because we've factored f of x. So we have x minus 4 in the numerator, and we also have x minus 4 in the denominator. So a hole will occur at x equals 4. Now we need to figure out the coordinates of that hole. To do that, we need to look at a function that is equal to f of x everywhere except at x equals 4. And that happens at g of x is equal to 2x minus 1 over x plus 2. So you notice the only difference between f of x and g of x is that in g of x we have canceled out the x minus 4 factors. Now, we can't do that in f of x, or we would change who f of x is. But what we're doing here is making a new function that agrees with f of x everywhere, except at x equals 4. So to find the location of the hole, what we do is we plug in x equals 4 to g of x. So if we look at g of 4, we're going to get 2 times 4 minus 1, divided by 4 plus 2, which is equal to 7 over 6. So then that means f of x will have a hole at 4, 7 over 6. In example B, we have g of x is equal to x squared minus 9 over x squared plus 4x plus 3. So just like in the previous example, the first order of business is to factor. Now the numerator is quite easy to factor. We recognize that it's the difference of two squares, so that's going to factor into x minus 3 times x plus 3. In the denominator, we can come over and do our AC method factoring. We need two numbers that multiply to be positive 3, but that add to be positive 4. Most of you probably see right away this is going to be a positive 3 times a positive 1. So the denominator has a leading coefficient of 1, which means we can go immediately to the factors using these numbers. So we get x plus 3 times x plus 1. Now, using the same rules as we did just a minute ago, we know that the roots of this function will occur when the numerator is equal to 0, but the denominator is not 0. The denominator equals a number at that location. So the numerator is equal to 0 at x equals 3 and at x equals negative 3. So we know there is a root at x equals 3, but there is not a root at x equals negative 3, because even though the numerator is 0 at negative 3, the denominator is also 0 there. So we can't use that one. So the root then will be at 3, 0. Next, we can find the vertical asymptotes of the function. The vertical asymptotes of the function occur when the denominator is equal to 0, but the numerator is not. The denominator is equal to 0 at negative 3 and at negative 1. However, at negative 3, the numerator is also 0, so we know that that is not a vertical asymptote. So the only vertical asymptote of this function is x equals negative 1. The holes for g of x will occur when the denominator and the numerator are both equal to 0 at the same x value. In our case, it's easy to see that this occurs when x is equal to negative 3. And remember, we said to look for holes, we're going to look for the common factors. So the hole occurs at x equals negative 3. Now, to find the y value, we need to come up with a function that agrees with g of x everywhere except at negative 3. So that function would be h of x equals x minus 3 divided by x plus 1. So now, if we plug x equals negative 3 into h of x, we get h of negative 3 is equal to negative 3 minus 3 divided by negative 3 plus 1, and we find out we get negative 6 divided by negative 2, which is equal to 3. So we know that the hole in g of x is going to occur at negative 3, 3.